this year, later on this year, so this buys out, they would be great, but even though I live somewhere, they really do. We'll come off those peaks. Now, as long as you didn't buy your house last August, let's say, but if you're a flipper or a speculator, I'm not going to lose any sleep over you. And a lot of people won't, no sympathy whatsoever. But if you are there to use your house as your house, and on the longer term, values are going to be okay, they're going to be supported, I think. Right now, of course, you've got this big discrepancy. You've got people who sell their house, you think they own Knox and it's worth all this money. And then you've got guys who really buy it saying, oh, no, I own the Wall Street Journal, it's worth this much. So you've got a very big discrepancy. We saw a discrepancy last year. I'd say if these two would be kind of doing it, well, if you think the price is right, if you're a risky agent, then great. If you don't, walk away, but somebody else have a grief. Is that this out there or not? You are seeing a big disparity. But I only think that we'll see a decline this year, but it will not be dramatic at all. Permit levels, you know, some new construction, yeah, we're off 22%.
From new construction companies' standpoint, that's why we tend to like to use assessors data. One in 10 condos, new construction condos, fixed on the MLS. It annoys me to death. Because I'd like to get those numbers, but you just don't get them, unfortunately. You used to, but that's not a few years ago. So you've got to look at it with a little bit of scrutiny in that respect. So 2009, what do I think? Better situation to come towards the end of the year. I think a lot of the fences are going to unseat themselves. They're going to get back in the marketplace. Foreclosure activity, yeah, that's going to peak. We saw next month it comes up, peaking adjustable arms, 9 days thereafter. And so those units will start coming to market. But we haven't got that much of exposure here. A good thing. Long-term, short-term rates, they're going to decline. Pre-promising will be tougher to get. And I said, we've gone for the supply to the ridiculous. A couple of years ago, I said, my dog was being sent an invitation for a mortgage. Now you've got to have a FICO score above 800, not to pay points. So that is going to be interesting to see how that plays out. They are going to be more difficult to obtain, simple as that. Well, I think we'll move back to positive price appreciation in 2009. You say, well, positive, yeah, we'll be a little positive. You know, you went between 0-3% going forward. I like that. Those kind of appreciations in value are sustainable. Is 10, 12, 14% things, they're not. And if you go back to, well, yeah, that was the kind of appreciation we were seeing in our marketplace back in the 90s, believe it or not. It's only the early 90s. And even we jumped up in the mid 90s and dropped back down in the late 90s, that's okay. You said we should be looking at this as something our retirement account. We'll get back to that, and more rational increase in values. Refinancing, there's going to be so much refinancing going on this year, it's going to be scary, locally and nationally. Especially if rates decline any further than they are right now. They're about 5.5 right now. Fed funds rate comes down, linked to the 10-year Treasury note, then we'll start seeing some further declines. We're going to be price negative this year. That is okay. It really is. Again, it depends on which way you look at it. And the investors are going to have a bit of an issue, potentially, depending on when they bought. But we say we're protected, we think we're special in South, but and to a degree we are. But we can't escape wholeheartedly. There were some huge drops in value. We got a lot of fence sitters. It depends on whether the buyers and sellers start seeing eye to eye again. The Russell came in, it's a deceleration, it's not a bust. I don't think it's a bust at all. So market activity will go on. I think a lot of these buyers will say, well, we start seeing a calming on Wall Street. I'm going to do the same thing back in 2001. I get my IRA account statement. I throw it in the corner, I don't even bother opening it. And then later this year, I might take a little tiny peek inside. So I think when we start seeing a calming down effect on Wall Street, we're not so schizophrenic, which is really what we are right now. That will help us in general. Enterprise growth, it's going to turn around. I do have concerns on new construction companies. We've already seen two projects in Seattle. One's going to be converted to an apartment, one's for sale, both being developed by Intercom. So they're looking at it. And again, it depends on how leveraged the builders are. Builders are great spenders of other people's money. They really are. They're slowing down right now because their requirements for equity have doubled, at least. But you're beholden to them. This is something we're trying to finish off with. This is the number of you guys that are out there watching the same. And the growth. Now you can see that 2005 and 6, or 4 and 5, were pretty good years. Market's going dramatically up. This percentage increase in the number of real estate agents. Something happened in 07, big Roman oil. And I think we'll actually probably see a decline in the number of Asians coming this year. Every time I give that speech to real estate agents, I always get the same response. Yeah! We see, we're already seeing major declines in California, major declines in Florida, and in Phoenix and in Vegas, possibly in Vegas, yeah. But we will see that coming down this year. I don't think it's a bad thing at all. So to conclude, a friend of mine from Miami sent me this thing. St. Joseph's Statue of Independence. Apparently, you bury something underneath the Excel sign and house sales. And then it comes complete with a listing, complimentary home listing kit. I don't think we'll need this year. I think it's going to be a more regular year than we saw over the last several. That's okay. These declines in value are going to happen. They are going to be temporary, but we can't escape them. We're protected, we're not completely protected. The buyers that are out there are going to get off the fence later on this year. We see some calming down. And then going forward, we'll continue to grow. We've got too much water, too many mountains not to grow. So unless we see something calamitous occur in the national economy, you look on two sides of it, it's a glass half full or half empty. I'm still saying in Seattle it's half full. And with that, I'd be happy to answer any questions you might have. Dennis is going to have a PDF of my back.
I want to
start
to replace the fact that people are talking about Seattle becoming a super city. Do you think that compares
to London, New York, Los Angeles, right? Seattle is a super city. I was talking to some guys from the Urban Land Institute about this a while ago. I'm speaking about it down in San Francisco next month. We are not yet the top tier city in Seattle. There's a lot more things we need to do. The biggest things we need to do to fix transportation. Portland built more condos downtown last year than we did in Seattle. Portland's got the max. Now, max will never make any money. That's okay. They're Oregonians, so you've got to get used to that kind of thing. But it doesn't matter. So we haven't got that, we haven't got the bars, I mean, we're going to get, eventually, the Link Light Rail, it's going to go from the U District down to the airport. But right now, we are doing feasibility.